Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasanagam University, India. Today's topic is false lects of properties of systems. Today's stable and unstable and FIR, IIR systems. Also, I have lectured to you for this in my lecture number 8. Okay, and for linear and non-linear system, my lecture number 9, and time variant and time invariant, my lecture 10th, my lecture. You can review this one for. This is the final lecture for the properties of systems. Okay, then what is the stable and unstable? That means, okay, this is inputs and output, and this is impulse response. Now I used here the terminology bounded input, and bounded output. Anyway, we can get a bound input when bounded input applied at this one. We call this stable system. Stable system. Then, what is a bounded? Bounded meaning is this. Magnitude of input. Okay, this means is a finite value. Also, and this one also, x of n also a finite value. Of course, this is continuous time signal. This is discrete time signal. Okay, bounded output also, y of t. Magnitude of y of t has always finite value, means less than infinity. And also, discrete case, also magnitude equal less than infinite, finite value. We call this stable systems. Okay. And for example, x of t is here, for example, this kind of signal. Okay, this is, as you know, bounded input produce bounded output for this, okay, this. That means we call this a bounded stable. No, stable system. Because output also bounded. There's no infinite signals, okay? Therefore, this is a stable system. And also, in this case, bounded inputs produce some kind of this, infinite. Then bounded input, but in this case not bounded input, because some value of yt goes to infinite. Therefore, we call this unstable system. Okay, not bounded output. Therefore, we call this unstable. In case of a discrete time also, input. So for example, this one, this another thing is all zero. This is bounded input, and also here, like this, sometime this, zero, zero, zero. This is a bounded output. Therefore, we call this stable system. Okay. Then so far I explained what is the bounded input and what is the bounded output. Like this, I explained it. Okay. Then, and what is the criteria for a bounded input and the bounded output? Like this. In case of continuous time signals and in discrete time case. Now impulse response. Impulse response, the summation of impulse response should be a finite value, not infinite. This means finite. Okay, this is necessary and sufficient condition for the stability of the systems. Okay, then let me check the stability of the this kind of systems. Okay, first of all, this one. Okay, now this one. Okay, we need to check the impulse response, but now here we do not know impulse response. Okay, we do not know impulse response. But here, this is definitely we can check yt is infinite or not infinite for all t. Now you can see here t goes to infinite. Then now this goes yt goes to infinite. Therefore, this is not bounded output. Bounded output. Therefore, this is unstable systems. Okay. Okay. Now, in this case, let me check this one. Okay. Now, y sub t at this equal this condition. Equal 1 plus something and the ut. Ut means t equal 0 to infinity. Therefore, integral 0 to infinity instead of this. Because of this, therefore, 1 plus exponential minus 2t dt equal, you know, from this t. Plus 1 by minus 2 exponential minus 2t here 0 to infinity equal, you can see here very easily t equals to infinity, then this means infinite, therefore this is also unstable system. Okay, how about this next question here? Yt equal this. This also integral. Because of this, we can integrate 0 to infinite exponential 2t dt equal 1 by 2 exponential 2t 0 to infinite. That's definite. Now here, t goes to infinite. This is infinite. That is also unstable systems. Okay, next. This one. Now this one. Now y of n equal 5x n minus t. For this, we need impulse response h of n. Okay, h of n. What is impulse response? Now, previous my lecture number 7, impulse response, I said already, impulse response means y of n when x of n equals 0 of n. Therefore, from this, y of, h of n equals 5, instead of this delta function, n minus 2, okay. This means it's very easy to know n equals 2, then equal 2, amplitude equal 5. Another thing is all 0. Therefore, summation hn equal just 5. Therefore, this is finite. This is a stable system. Okay. And this y of n equal this one. Then also from this h of n equal from this 0 of n minus 2 from this 0 of n minus 1 plus 3 from this 0 of n minus 5. Okay. Therefore, in this case also now, n equal here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then the, n equal 0, magnitude equal 1. N equal 1, magnitude minus 2. N equal 0, 0, 0. N equal 5, magnitude equal 3. Another thing is 0, 0, 0. Therefore, summation hn is not less than infinite, finite value. Okay, summation. Okay. Yeah. summation, summation HN. Therefore, this is also stable system. Okay, how about this? Okay, now this means, you can say, summation. Summation H of N equal, N equal, because of U and N equal 0 to infinity, equal summation N equal 0 to infinity to power of N. Equal definitely, this means N, okay, now equal 1 plus 2 plus 2 square plus 2, this is definitely, this is infinity. Therefore, we call this unstable systems. Okay. Next, finite FIR and IIR. F, okay, now, here. F means finite, okay. F means, sorry. F means finite. I means infinite. This IR means impulse response. Okay. Already in previous my lecture 7, my lecture 7, I explained what is the impulse response. This impulse response, input, output, this one. Now, let's just focus on this impulse response. Now here, how many numbers of signals are in H of N impulse response? Okay, how many numbers of this here? For example, if the number of signals in HN is finite, we call this finite impulse response, FIR. For example, H of N equal this one, 0.1, del of n, 0.2, del n minus 1, 0.3, or the matter. This one, n equals 0, 0.1, 2, 3, like that. Then here, how many numbers of inputs here? 1, 2, 3. Three numbers of signals. Therefore, we call this finite. This is a 3, finite value. Therefore, we call this finite impulse response. Another thing, in this case, number is of infinite numbers, okay? Then we can say infinite impulse response. For example, now here, h of n equal here, n plus 1, n equal 0, 1, n equal 1, 2, 3, go to, n goes to infinite. This is also h of n equal infinite. Therefore, the number of signals, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this is infinite numbers, infinite numbers. Therefore, we call this IIR, infinite impulse response. Okay? And also, in this case, FIR case, how about this one? This can go to infinite? No, absolutely cannot. This is one of the some value. Some value, finite value, a finite value. Therefore, in this is always, in this case, always a stable system. Okay, in case of FIR, FIR is always stable. But in this case, how about this? Can you say this is a finite value? No, because the number of infinite. Therefore, sometime infinite, finite value was sometime infinite value. Therefore, we cannot say this IIR is always stable. Therefore, IIR is sometime stable or sometime unstable systems. Okay? Sometime stable, sometime unstable for the IIR system. And one more, another characteristic of IIR is this one. Now, input, output. Now you can see feedback concept is here. Because of this, this is feedback, okay? Feedback. Because of this, sometimes the stable is stable, otherwise unstable. Okay, but in other case, there is no feedback, no feedback. Okay, but in other case, feedback is there. Okay, thank you so much for your watching. Today I lectured final of the properties of systems. Those are stable or unstable, and FIR and IIR. How do we know? How do you check whether the system is stable or unstable? FIR and IIR. Next topic is now just I'm used the X over very much time. Then how to convert from this continuous to discrete time? How to convert? This one kind of some sampling problems. Let me explain. Okay, please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.